And the words are these: Om Namo Guru Dev Namo. And it means I call on my higher self, my inner strength, to help me do my best. So you do your best and do it out loud as we do it three times. Close your eyes. Inhale. Om. Straight inhale, relax the breath, and just meditate for a moment. Close your eyes and focus at the brow, and let me reiterate, let Sat Nam and the breath be one. Inhale Sat, exhale Nam, and be one with the one, the real you, the experience of infinity that you were born to embody. Now it's time to continue. So grab your shins, get a good grip, and you're going to flex your spine. As you inhale, you flex forward and exhale back. Keep your face forward. Just move your lower back. So inhale forward, exhale back. Begin. That's it. This is called camel ride because it looks like you're riding a camel. You're as flexible as your spine is flexible and as young as your spine is flexible. The spine is a conduit for the central nervous system and a conveyance for spirit rising. Kundalini, the energy of your higher potential. So access this energy of spirit and flex your spine. This type of exercise will insulate you against serious injury, make you resilient. Slower. Find a rhythm that's right for you and ride that rhythm. And as you're doing it, focus with the prow. Inhale, subject single. Okay, now inhale straight. Hold the breath. And now let the breath go and meditate before we go on. Focus at the brow. Consolidate your gaze. For the previous exercise, we're going to complement it. So put your hands up, fingers in front, thumbs in back. And as you inhale, you turn left. And as you exhale, turn right. And continue on your own at a good speed. Inhale left, exhale right. That's it. Good. Sat Nam, Sat Nam. Not only is this for your lower back, but your heart and lungs will benefit all the internal organs, your solar plexus. To open and more. Now focusing at the brow helps you not to get dizzy. Among more important things. So meditate as you move. Your spine in this pose. Inhale forward, exhale back. So when you see what to do, then you do it too. Just move your midriff. That's it. In fact, this may be one of the hardest exercises we'll do. And know this, the ability to relax is a great and graceful art. So let yourself go. Let yourself know that the ability to relax is both a right and a responsibility. So relax and relate your finite self to infinity. And let the song Sat Nam soothe you.
relax and float and devote this time to the sublime. Relax, release, find peace. Continue on your own, slowly to inhale up and exhale down. When you come up, you can open your eyes so as not to get dizzy. That's it. If you sit at a desk all day or do a lot of driving, this is an important exercise for your upper back. So you won't get bowled over permanently in later years. So work your upper back, work your heart center, find this blend and more. That's it. By your sides and drop your head forward and very slowly begin to roll your head around in a big slow circle. Circumnavigate your neck. Follow the course of the collarbone. Roll your head around. That's it. This exercise is very simple, but in fact is very profound. You're reinstating circulation to your brain. Do you know that sometimes we get headaches because our brains are oxygen deprived? So give your brains some circulation out there. That's it. Your thoughts being helped, your memories being helped, and more. This exercise is a beauty enhancer because when the cells in the face get oxygen, wrinkles don't have to be a reality. Now put your head in reverse and go the other way. Reverse. Roll your head around. Try to do this one every day, come what may. Something this simple can make a difference in your life if done on a regular basis. So roll your head around. Now, if you have fused vertebrae or any kind of neck problem, don't drop your head back. Simply draw a circle in the air with your nose. Otherwise, roll your head around. That's it. The breath and just meditate for a moment. Relax your throat and face and eyes. And now it's time to do cat cow. So come onto your hands and knees, please. There you go. Now as you inhale, raise your head up and press your stomach down. As you exhale, drop your head and curve your spine. Continue at a moderate pace. Inhale up and exhale down. Good. Find a rhythm that's right for you. If you'd like to go slower than this, that's okay too. The beginning had just begun. toes up and line your back again. Line your back again before we go on. Relax. 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 That's it. And feel like you're floating.
Feel like a
white cloud in the blue sky.
We need to relax.
Like the hurrying wind. Let the thought of your higher self be unfurled away. Release the breath. There's something you have to learn. It's called the breath of fire. It's an important tool that we use. It does a lot for you quickly. So here's how it's done. The breath of fire is a rapid rhythmic breath through your nose. It puts an equal emphasis on the inhale and exhale. It sounds like this. Do it slower at first until it becomes relaxed and rhythmic. Have your feet flat and knees bent. And press your hips up in the air. And interlace your fingers under you. Okay, hold this pose and begin the breath of fire. For a few moments, let the breath of fire continue to work for you in a more subtle sense now. Relax. Okay, continue we must. So grab your knees, wrap your arms around your knees, raise your head and rock on your spine. Rock and roll. And now come up with your legs in front of you and have your arms parallel to the ground, thumbs coming straight up. Now inhale, lean back 30 degrees, and exhale forward 30 degrees. Continue on your own to inhale back and exhale forward. Breathe deep. This works the kidneys, adrenals, and the solar plexus for flexibility's sake and more. So inhale back, exhale forward, and continue. Persevere. That's it. Your legs down and breathe long and deep through your nose, stretching out in this pose. Long, deep breathing. That's it. Concentrate on such love. Bring your whole being to this thing. It'll bring more than that back to you. That's the law. Good. Keep breathing. Side to side the same way, and now have your legs wide apart,
And you're going to inhale up and exhale down to either side of successive exhales. Inhale up, exhale one side, inhale up, exhale the other, and continue. That's it. Your legs up and down, and turn your feet from side to side. Okay. Now with your legs in front of you, pull down, hold your feet, pull down. If you cannot hold your feet, hold your ankles, calves, and knees. Just drop your head, relax down, but use your arm strength to help you go down further. Lift your arms, and begin a breath of fire. Rapid breath through your nose. We're working on what's called a sciatic nerve. We call it the life nerve in yoga. It's the longest nerve in the nervous system, and it's a barometer, basically, for the state of your health and well-being. Thumbs up, the arms are 60 degrees. Breath of fire. This is for your magnetic field and radiance. When you have a strong magnetic field, you're literally insulated against negativity and mishap. Not only that, but you transform negativity into positivity or repel it. This one's good to do before an interview or before you go out. Feeling strong, you're consistently in the right place at the right time, and you're more consistently lucky. Because luck is not luck, it's the ability to compute beyond time and space through the force of your radiance and sensitivity. And that's what this exercise will give you. Now inhale deep, hold the breath, and slowly bring your thumbs towards one another. Feel where your thumbs are. be super sensitive. Closer and closer, closer and closer. Now let your thumb tips meet. And relax the breath and let the thumbs disconnect and the arms float down as if through water. Describe a rainbow of radiance around you. And when the arms get down, meditate like a master. Wrists on the knees, index finger and thumb tips meeting. Go deep within. And now, reap the dividends on the investment you made with your time and effort. Focus with the brow and meditate like a master. Inhale, sat, exhale, nam. And forego the disaster of a fate in favor of a destiny. Be focus itself. Your eyes are turned up to the brow. And go deep. And reside where your true home is. Exercise is to go into the world and be great and graceful, sensitive and strong, to be the light and spread the light on behalf of all beings.